If you have difficulty reading, driving at night, or you think your vision looks like a foggy window, you may have cataracts.
Well, here to tell us about the signs, symptoms, and treatment for cataracts is Dr. Ernest Bhend with Charlotte Eye, Ear, Nose, and Throat Associates. How are you doing today, sir?
Good, thank you.
Welcome to the show,
thank
indeed.
Thank you for having me.
Let's talk about this. What are some signs that we may be experiencing cataracts?
Yeah, so typically just some blurriness of the vision, or some people think it looks foggy or like a haze. Mm-hmm. Those are the typical symptoms patients will report.
And do most of us get them?
Yeah, if you have enough birthdays, you'll eventually develop cataracts. That's what I tell most patients. It's typically just an aging process of the lens inside the eye. So eventually it can get cloudy over time.
At what point are we supposed to see a doctor then?
If the vision's getting blurry enough that glasses alone or contacts alone aren't taking care of it and it still looks blurry, that's when we usually recommend having those checked.
Talk about this picture that we're seeing here,
sure.
Dr. Bhend, if you wouldn't mind, on the left and on the right.
So the pictures on the left are just kind of normal vision as far as how it should look, nice and clear. And then the pictures on the right side of the screen show kind of the glare or halo effect you can sometimes get, especially at nighttime. The lights can actually scatter and you get a lot of halo effect. The other picture just showed a lot of blurriness. The image just looks blurry, almost like looking through water or looking through a fog or a film.
So what are some of the risk factors for cataracts?
So potential things that can lead to cataracts, again, aging is a big one. Injury to the eye can certainly do that. Certain medications like steroids and that sort of thing can do it. Previous surgeries to the eyes can cause cataracts. And sometimes even just a family history of cataracts, you can have them at a younger age. Diabetes is another big risk factor for cataracts.
What about treatment for cataracts? How do you treat this?
So the way we treat a cataract, we remove the cloudy lens from the eye and replace it with a new clear artificial lens so that the eye can still focus properly. Mm-hmm. And it's done surgically. It's a 10-minute procedure. Typically only takes about 10 minutes or so. It's very quick. And the surgery is probably one of the easiest surgeries to go through. We do it under anesthesia, and we put medicine on the eye to numb the eye so it doesn't hurt during the surgery. Mm-hmm. Very quick. And the eye heals very quickly, so usually within a week it's pretty well healed.
It's amazing. So, that's amazing. Yeah. It's only 10 minutes, too.
Yes, yeah, so are we talking about if you have cataracts in both eyes, do you do one eye at a time, week at a time? Is that correct?
We do one at a time. We usually will let the first eye heal for about 2 or 3 weeks before going back and doing the second eye, just to make sure there's no infection or swelling or any other problems with that first eye.
And again, the downtime, it's not that long to speak of.
For the first week, we ask patients not to lift more than about 20 pounds or so. Don't want you driving the first couple days afterwards until the vision clears. But that's usually about it as far as any restrictions go. Mm-hmm. And most patients, the vision improves even within the first couple days after the surgery, and it's pretty well healed within about a week or two.
Does it affect your close-up vision too, or is it just what you're seeing far away?
It does. So with the new lens we put inside the eye, we try to reduce the need for glasses as much as we can. The standard lens implants are primarily set for distance correction. So everything from about arm's length on out, we try to reduce that need for glasses. But up close, most patients will still need some reading glasses or a bifocal with that.
Sure.
There are some newer lens options on the market now that work kind of like a bifocal lens inside the eye. And so that is an option if patients are trying to get away from needing reading glasses or a bifocal as well.
Amazing.
Yeah, the technology's really come a long way.
Yes, it really has. Well, he's your guy. If you want more information, call 704-295-3000, 704-295-3000 for Charlotte Eye, Ear, Nose, and Throat Associates, or visit their website, wejustmakesense.com. Wejustmakesense.com. And they really do. If you've got a problem, call today and schedule an appointment. Dr. Bhend, thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Yeah, appreciate it.